हेलो हेलो हाँ
या सर, या सर।
डॉक्टर गौरंग शाह सर विल ज्वाइन सून। आई स्पोक विथ हिम।
ओके सर, ओके सर।
गुड इवनिंग सर।
आवाज हेलो
गुड इवनिंग सर।
या गुड इवनिंग, गुड इवनिंग डॉक्टर गीतेश ज्वाइन।
लेट मी सी सर। No, sir, he has not joined.
Okay, I'll just telephone him. Dr. Maheshwari has joined.
No, sir, no, sir.
Dr. Gita is joining. Okay, this is to all the who is going to answer now?
So Dr. Kiran from Manipal, Bangalore. Dr. Anush Dumra from SSI HMS, Puttaparthi. And Dr. Kaushal Kondawar from King's Trivandrum.
One second. Anuj, first Anuj Dumra and?
Kiran, sir. Kiran, Anuj, Kaushal and Jay Joshi.
Jay Joshi, na?
Yes, sir.
So all are unmuted?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now before Dr. Gite and all join, only there is one question that next time also we are going to do OSCE. So in that, you want 45 minutes like 8:30 to 9:15 so that everyone can, you know, we will give display these slides for five minutes with four or five questions below and everyone can answer it and then we will discuss. You want that way, that pattern? Because last year we had done it and it was very useful to everyone. In this OSCE, you will get slides only for 5 minutes. And this slide will not be repeated. And in some cases, they may take away your answer sheet also. So every time you answer, they take away, or at the end of the slideshow, they will take it away. So now you have to make that habit that in 5 minutes, you have to answer all four questions. Usually they are each of 2 marks. So 8 marks per slide. And it will not be repeated. You will not be given a second chance. So I think it is advisable that all of you practice in that way. So yes, Kaushal, if you are unmute, what do you think?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Would like to follow your advice.
So next time, that is what we will do. We will tell them to start at 8:30. From 8:30 to 9:15, we will have 8 or 9 slides being displayed only for five minutes. All of you can answer. And after 9:15, we will discuss out all the questions. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Dr. Gita has joined.
No, sir.
Yeah, he's joining. I just told him.
Okay, sir.
We'll just wait for...
Hello.
Pankaj bhai. Dr. Gaurang sir, bol raha hu.
Boliye sir, boliye.
Joining?
Sir, sir, wo bhul gaya
sir. Okay, okay. Yeah, Dr. Pankaj Maheshwari is also joining. Okay, just give me 2 minutes and then we'll start. Any suggestion, please, you can put it into chat box.
Gita sir has joined, sir.
X-rays and CT scan.
Sorry, completely forgotten, sir.
No problem. They are all waiting. So you have joined and Dr. Maheshwari is also joining. So shall we start?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And someone has, Dr. Krunal has asked, would it be topic-wise? Now, which way you want? So if you want topic-wise... See, we are discussing like OSCE as well as a table. So today we are going to have a OSCE. At the same time, the same questions, same X-rays will be asked on the table also, like CT scan, sonography, X-ray. So we will discuss in the same way. The same way we can have pathology also and to some extent instruments. Long case and short case we have already discussed. So... otherwise, OSCE, what else you want? Which other topic you want? Radiology and instruments, these are the two important tables. So, Kaushal, Jai.
Yes, sir.
can you suggest?
No, sir. Radiology and instruments are.
So radiology most probably will be discussing today most of the thing. If anything is remaining, we can do it next time. Otherwise, mostly, na, like last time, we will have lots of things. We will have videos. We will have some case presentation. Last time we discussed about 45 OSCE, and out of that 30 have come. And the patho slides are also asked. So we will discuss about 6 to 7 patho slides. Then if you want urodynamics, we will again like last time we'll have a urodynamic one session. So in next 3 Tuesdays we should finish off everything. Correct? Okay. So Dr. Gitesh, shall we start?
And yes, sir.
Yeah. And patho slides also, pathology, gross specimen, and slides. Both will come. We'll do it that way. Okay.
Hello. Sir, should I start?
Yes, yeah.
Yes, sir. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Clinics for PG Updates, an educational initiative by Dr. Gaurang Shah and Dr. Venkat Gite. Today's session is OSCE tables of uroradiology. This is for Dr. Kaushal. A 40-year-old male patient presented with hematuria, and these are the some of the plates. First plate is this one.
These are the two.
Yes. Yes. 40-year-old male patient with hematuria.
Okay. We have plain films?
No, this is OSCE. You cannot ask anything.
Okay.
Sir, should I show questions?
Yeah. Just ask the questions now.
Yes.
Put the questions.
Yes. First question is spot the diagnosis.
This is a CT scan of abdomen pelvis showing the mass in the bladder.
Only that much?
With diverticulum is also there, sir.
Keep that CT film on so that he can again if you want to revise it. Because time to come, bahut kam milta hai. So very less time. You have to take judgment in short time.
So tell us properly where it is.
The mass is near the right ureteric orifice. It's occupying the right ureteric orifice. Around 1 centimeter mass.
And it is causing what?
Hydronephrosis also there, sir. Right-sided hydroureteronephrosis.
So now if you are going to get one mark, so what will be your diagnosis?
Sir, this is a okay. So right mass in the urinary bladder near the right ureteric orifice causing right hydroureteronephrosis.
Time you heard? Come on fast. In one mark, how much you are going to say? Is a mass in the bladder at the ureteromesenchymal junction, right sided
hydronephrosis. Yes, sir.
Correct. Most probably it is TCC.
TCC.
Right? So that is
yes, sir.
Okay. Next question.
Yes, sir. Enumerate the test to confirm your diagnosis.
Urine cytology and CT urography with biopsy, T or BT, sir.
CT urography is already given.
Beta. Already given, yes, sir. TURB, we will take a cystoscopic biopsy and urine cytology.
Yes. Fine. Okay. We'll discuss later on. The third thing.
Yes, sir. Sir, should I go for next question?
Yeah.
how will you counsel the patient? This is for 4 marks.
Sir, I will tell the patient that there is some mass lesion in the bladder. I will inform with the sympathy and empathy that there is some mass lesion in the bladder which needs a biopsy and then further evaluation. If it turns out to be malignant, we needs a further extensive workup with metastatic workup, and then we'll decide on the further plan of management.
See, in 4 marks, you have to answer everything.
Yes,
correct?
Sir.
So,
yes, sir.
First of all, when you are going to do TURBT,
yes, sir.
There are chances that you will damage the ureterovesical junction.
Yes.
So, what will do then?
You may need a DJ stenting after removal of the mass lesion.
So,
and so depending on the histopathological report, we'll plan further management.
So first of all, you are going to tell them that what you are going to do in the first stage, you are going to remove this mass, and there are chances that you might have to put a DJ stent. Then you are going to slowly explain them that there are chances that this may turn out to be
malignant lesion.
Malignant lesion. Now, if it is a malignant lesion, what are the chances? What you can do? What are the 3 options you have got?
Yes, sir. We can, depending on the grade of the malignancy, we can start intravesical therapy with the BCG or mitomycin. If it is a high grade, we eliminate a radical surgery.
Suppose if it is in the lower ureter, it is not involved in the bladder.
Yes, if it is in the lower ureter, we may need a radical nephroureterectomy.
Is there any
with the cup of bladder? Or... Yeah. Yeah.
Is there anything else you can do?
If it is in the lower ureter, sir, we can excise the excise the mass and do ureteroneocystostomy.
Okay. Apart from that, what else you can do?
We can start, sir, new adjuvant chemotherapy.
If you can
and
remove this mass.
Yes, sir.
Kaushal.
Yes, sir.
After seeing this CT scan closely,
yes,
it is a bladder mass involving the lower ureter with UV junction. If
yes.
you see, take a lower down second or third pill, the lumen of the lower ureter is completely filled with the mass.
Yes.
So that mass may be coming from ureter to the bladder or bladder to the ureter. You cannot judge on the CT urography. So it is a bladder mass involving the lower ureter. That will be with proximal hydrotor, complete proximal hydrotor nephrotomy.
Yes.
Mild to moderate, mild bowel septic, moderate bowel septic. This is the first answer to the first question. Second question, how will you diagnose? The diagnosis is, that means he wants a histopathological diagnosis. So cytology and cystoscopic biopsy is another answer to that. So biopsy, while resection, if you have to,
yeah.
you have to resect.
Sir, someone has asked about even MRI.
MR, sir, MR is already it is involving the lower ureter and in 1 film it is starting in the bladder. So either of the way it is involving the lower ureter and bladder. So there is no any specific role in this case for MRI. That's what I feel. Treatment of lower ureteric mass with bladder mass is after doing the resection, it is a low grade or high grade. According to that, we have to give the treatment. And presence of multiple rest of the patches inside the bladder, that is CIST, to rule out the CIST, any small masses in the bladder. So that will be decided on doing the cystoscopy. If it is a lower ureteric mass involving the bladder, and if it is high grade, definitely there is a radical nephrectomy.
another option, if patient general condition is not too good, the another option is distal ureteroscopy with lymph node dissection. Another thing is, if it is low grade, again, then if it is at the junction of the urethra and bladder, so again, distal ureteroscopy will suffice as an alternative to radical nephrectomy for distal ureteric mass. Another question asked in the chat is the role of ureteroscopy.
Excellent.
The question put there.
Yeah, so correct. So he is, you understood Dr. Gita has said what?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. And then you can do either, and if it is a low grade, then you can do endourology. You can use laser, you can excise the mass, and you can give the conservative line of treatment. Or if you want, you can do lower and ureterectomy and re-anastomosis. Okay. Or if it is a high grade, nephroureterectomy, same way. If it is in the bladder involving the right ureteric orifice, again you can do resection, you can send it for the biopsy, you can do DJ stenting. Then depending upon the report, you have to decide what you want to do, and depending upon the condition of the patient, whether you want to go ahead with a conservative line of treatment or you want to do radical treatment. That is okay. Yes, yes, Kunal has asked something.
Another question, ureteroscopy has to be done to evaluate the ureter. That is, if the CT urography doesn't show any mass filling defect proximally, and if mass is coming from the ureter, then you have to go for ureteroscopy and check for another lesion, that is true. But if it is starting inside the bladder and going or involving the lower ureter, as not a, involvement of lower ureter, then there is no role of doing the ureteroscopy proximally, because already CT urography is normal. If there is a free mass coming from the lumen of the ureter, then we have to go for to the biopsy and see proximal some synchronous lesions. Ureteroscopy karna jaruri.
Kunal, you discuss
it. It should be a radical procedure. Ideally, sir, please correct me if I am wrong. I also told the same thing. If it is a low grade mass, any distal ureteric mass, it may be low or high grade, can be done primarily with radical nephrectomy if it is involving the bladder as well as ureter. Then radical nephrectomy, and if it is muscle invasive, then radical cystectomy with radical nephrectomy. That will be the answer. And if it is only the coming from the ureter, and if rest of the bladder is normal, then the distal ureterectomy with the cup of the bladder and re-anastomosis and follow-up. That is another option for the mass involving the lower ureter coming to the bladder. Mass involving coming to the bladder option is distal ureterectomy with cup of the bladder plus minus adjuvant chemotherapy, and mass involving lower ureter or bladder with high grade lesion, then radical nephrectomy with radical cystectomy if it is muscle positive. If involvement of the lower ureter or presence of the hydrotonium process indirectly suggests of muscle invasive oblique T3 lesion, but histopathological diagnosis is mandatory.
Yeah, so I think that question that Campbell has said, it is very important that many a times when you see on X-ray or on CT scan, and you can't say, yes, it is a muscle invasive. It can be just an obstruction. We have seen, I have presented in one of our series also, you can go ahead and see that, and we have conserved. And now almost 2.5 years are over, and that patient has got no lesion. We have done PET scan, we have done CT scan repeatedly. It was similar mass. We have removed that mass. It was a low grade. We have given a BCG. We have done URS from the ureter. And even Dr. Ganesh Bakshi, we had discussed. And So if you feel that it is causing hydronephrosis, hydroureter, sometime it may be only into the lumen. And that is why
that doesn't mean it is a muscle invalid.
Yeah, so that is what I think that he has got. If it is in the ureter, no. So it should be a radical procedure, ideally, sir. Please correct me if I am wrong, by Kunal. So Kunal, that is what we are saying, that unless and until you go inside, you cannot be 100% sure. Okay, earlier it was considered like that, that, but now we have got so many modalities. So only on CT scan, you cannot say that it is muscle invasive and you will go ahead with a radical treatment. What is the last question? Prashant?
Yes, sir.
Pankaj bhai, you want to answer anything? You want to say anything?
As far as this decision about, say, whether hydronephrosis means muscle invasive, you see, if it's a bladder tumor with hydronephrosis, it is muscle invasive. But if it's a ureteric tumor, hydronephrosis may not mean muscle invasive.
And also, if it is a, I have seen that bladder mass, which is very near to the ureteric orifice, it is pressing over there. Many a times, you may develop a hydroureter.
Yes.
It may not be. It may be a low grade and may not be muscle invasive. So
absolutely.
That we have to keep that option open. We should not be dogmatic that Campbell has given. Yeah, most of the time you can say like that. But unless and until you do scopy, you do resection, TURBT, I think we cannot be judgmental that I will go and do the radical treatment.
True.
Okay, the last question, correct? Which are the next best management options in this patient?
This is for 2 marks.
Yes, sir. Sir, on the biopsy report, if it is a high grade, we'll do radical nephroureterectomy. And if it is low grade, we'll do segmental resection with neo-ureterostomy. Or the endoscopic option is also there, sir. It's conservative management if it is a low grade.
See, yeah, the question, you have already explained everything about the surgical.
Yes, sir.
But here the question is, which are the next best management options in this patient? See, understand, even the person who is going to ask you question in OSCE, okay, sometimes there may be something else in his mind. And whenever he's, because he has given you only one line or two liner. And in that one liner or two liner, you have to understand what he is trying to tell you. So if, how will you counsel this patient that you have already told? Huh? So here in 2 marks, you have to write the same thing. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Or he has asked, which are the next best management options? So you already explained them that these are the, what are the best option. So which are the next two best options that you have to answer?
Yes, sir. It depends on the biopsy report only, sir. If it is high grade, we'll do radical nephrectomy. If it is low grade, we'll do segmental resection with neocystectomy.
Okay.
Just, for sure, it, is, yes, it should be distal. If it is low grade, then distal ureterectomy with the cup of a bladder.
Cup of bladder, yes.
With ureteroneocystostomy.
Yes, sir.
That is the standard answer. Plus with plus minus uska jo histopathology report aayega uske hisab se fir screening karna intravascular chemotherapy dena nahi dena, that is depend upon the final histopathology.
See, this are the question.
Initial biopsy, if it is,
yeah sir, go ahead, I'll tell them later.
If it is initial diagnosis, initial biopsy, if it is suggested of low grade, then answer should be distal ureterectomy with cup of bladder with ureteroneocystostomy and post-op adjuvant intravascular chemotherapy or any other chemotherapies depend upon the final histopathology of patient. That is for low grade. And high grade, again, the answer is radical nephroureterectomy with cup of the bladder. And if it is involving the bladder, then again, it is with cystectomy. Because if it is involving the bladder, starting from bladder and going to the ureter, we have to remove bladder. Then it is like a bladder going to the ureter, then bladder plus ureter plus kidney, all you have to remove. If it is ureter coming to the bladder, then cup of the bladder and nephrectomy will suffice. plus minus new adjoint or adjoint chemotherapy. That will be the answer.
See, now you combine these two questions, then your answer is perfect, correct? So now how will you divide? The third question is for 4 marks. And the third and the fourth is for 2 marks. So how you are going to counsel the patient, you need not talk about the management. So in that you say everything, that it depends upon if it is a, like, you know, if it is in the only ureter not involving, you may, I just resect the thing. And I do
tight for a difficult answer, is there multiple options available.
But these are the questions which were asked last time also. So that is why they have to, because otherwise they will just keep on writing. So you can say that depending upon the tumor, where it is, and whether it is high grade or low grade, you will require to do ureteroscopy, removal of the mass, digest stenting, or you may do nephroureterectomy. And if it is involving the bladder, you may do nephroureterectomy. Along with that, radical cystectomy. Or if it is only the bladder, you will do radical cystectomy if it is a high grade. And if it is a low grade, you will do the conservative line of management. So that is a counseling. And which are the best next management option? Then you say as per Dr. Venkat Gite. Okay? Because you will not have enough of time. And there are chances that they will ask only one of these questions. So what is Virat's?
Sir, Virat's is a MRI staging system, T-staging of the bladder tumor. It is a vesicle imaging and imaging reporting and data system. So it has a 5 grades.
Yeah, tell us.
One, two are less likely to be malignant. 3 is equivocal. 4 and 5 are highly likely to be malignant.
So someone has correctly advised in the chat. If when such multiple answers are available, better way is do one flow diagram. That is ureter going to the bladder, bladder going to the ureter, low risk, high risk, first biopsy, then these are the options, and finally, एक ऐसा flow chart बना दिया तो उसका answer खत्म हो जाएगा. तो फिर अपन लिखते जाएंगे और time खत्म हो जाएगा.
Correct.
Flow chart. That is welcome suggestion by Jay.
Yeah. Flow chart is the best answer. If you can make a flow chart, it will be the best. So Virat, can someone answer? Anyone, any other student? Anyone is there? Who else is answering? Kiran? Kiran? Yeah.
No, sir. I don't know, sir.
Definition bolna hai ki it is vesicle imaging reporting and data system.
Yes, sir.
Uska phir 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Phir har ek ka system provides 5 points. Virat, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We suggest likelihood of detrusal muscle invasion.
See, the importance of this MRI is what? That last time also we discussed with Dr. Ganesh Bakshi and even with the radiologist from Tata, that if it is muscle invasive, nowadays the new theory is going to be that they are doing the research, that if it is showing definite muscle invasive, there is no need to take even a biopsy. You can just go ahead and do the radical cystectomy. So there is no need to go inside and do the cystoscopy, TURBT, and then decide. Okay.
Guidelines mein waisa aaya nahi hai abhi.
That is what they are saying.
Everywhere the option.
It is not question a guideline, is, but that is what the MRI is.
Can it avoid biopsy? That is the current debate and discussion, but it is not come into the guideline.
Yeah. Okay.
It is.
Yes. You want to say, Dr. Gita, anything else?
No, sir.
So can we proceed for the next one?
Sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Prashant.
Yes, sir. What is high wake?
What is high wake?
Sir, HIVAC is a hyperthermic instillation of the mitomycin C, sir. If some patients response to the mitomycin is not good, then we can try with hyperthermic mitomycin C.
Okay.
It is useful in the patients with BCG failure, sir.
Okay, fine. Akshay Nathani has joined. Can you just unmute him?
Yes, sir. I am here.
Yeah. So, Akshay, you have recently appeared for the exam. So, please answer them in between whatever you want to say.
Yes, sir.
So, anything in these six questions you want to elaborate?
I just want to tell them, be precise, be specific, and be fast, because we don't have any of the time there to think, because exam at that time we have thought block. So literally we have 5 minutes for each question, 8 marks per question, and we have to answer very specifically, and that too managing in a single sheet. It's a sheet only of one side. The other side, they don't allow us to answer write answers on other side of the sheet. And they immediately pick up our sheet after 5 minutes. So be precise, practice more and more, make use of these sessions a lot. Just that is the thing I want to tell you. The questions here okay. would be framed in such a way that it would be elaborative, more descriptive, but in exam, it will be more precise as compared to what we are discussing. We are trying to cover all the questions regarding the bladder mass and all, that you should not miss anything. And last time we have started first time OSCE, and luckily, 70 to 80% of questions we have already covered in this OSCE session, practice session. So make maximum use of it. And another thing I want to tell you is the next session which we will have, the interested candidate should take, literally it should be like an exam. You should start at 8:30 up to 9:15. You should mark your time, take your 15 to 20 sheets with you, mark the time and start writing as you are having practice session as an exam. Then 9:15, all the examiners will join and you see what you have written in that 5 minutes, where you are standing. Then accordingly, you can make yourself more perfect.
Fine.
Correct.
Okay. Anything you want to talk about Virad or HIVAC? You want to add anything?
Just hyperthermia. Why do we use hyperthermia in intravesical chemotherapy? It increases the perfusion of the chemotherapy agent. That was the concept behind introducing HIVAC. Actually, it's a special machine for introduction of intravesical chemotherapy.
Yeah, it is done in cochlear. Okay, can we go to the next slide?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Differential diagnosis of hematuria at the age of 40 year in male patient.
First differential diagnosis will be the urolithiasis. Second will be the ADPKD. Fourth will be PUGE obstruction, UTI, then cystitis, then CA bladder, then TCC of the upper tract.
So you can say urothelial carcinoma.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Dr. Gita, you want to add anything now?
No, sir.
Okay.
Sir, we have one more question.
Instillation in such patient.
If biopsy report is low grade urothelial carcinoma, then we can start with mitomycin.
Or when you are doing QRBT, and if you think
immediately after, yeah,
superficial, then you can immediately, no?
Yes.
Okay. Fine. Next, who is answering?
Sir, same person.
Okay. Abhishek has asked, will BPH be differential diagnosis not in 40 years? That is why it was very specifically asked. So you must read the question properly. If it is 60 years, it's a different thing. If it is 40 years, it's a different thing. If it is a child, you will talk of different thing. Okay? Fine. Okay, Kaushal, see this.
Yes.
Don't waste much time. Just see it and we will put a question. We don't want to waste the time. Okay, you have seen it?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Okay, questions?
Yes, sir. Identify the investigation done and what is the contrast agent used? This is for tumor.
This is a retrograde urethrogram. Contrast agent used is detrusoate meglumine or urografin. Yes.
Okay, next.
Position of the patient during investigation.
It is a semi-oblique position, 45 degree tilted to the table.
Left or right?
We can use any position, sir, left or right, according to convenience of the patient.
Convenience of patient or convenience of?
Imaging person.
Investigating person. Why?
Yes, sir.
Why you are putting it on the right side? Because you are righty.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you just elaborate how you are going to do it properly?
First film is taken as a scout film in supine position, and then we'll ask the patient to turn to the right lateral position with 45 degree oblique position. Then we'll stretch the penis, introduce a 14 French Foley's catheter in the navicular fossa with a 1 to 2 ml, we'll inflate the bulb, and then we'll inject a urografin dye, 20 to 30 ml. And take the images. Slowly we instill the dye and take the images.
Okay, next question.
Yes, sir. Spot the diagnosis.
This is a short segment bulbar urethral stricture.
What about distal?
Oi. Kaushal.
Yes, sir. Penile also urethral appears a small
happy,
segment.
Not happy with your answer. It is RGU. It is not RGU. It is retro urethrogram. Nowadays it is called as RUG. Already I have told in one class, but you have not probably forgotten. That is one. Another is when somebody has asked the position, then you should comment on that when it is called as a correct position. When it is called as a correct position. Put it right away. Radiological.
Radiological, sir. Yes, sir. One side obturator foramina,
yes,
should be obliterated. One should be
when
visible.
When you see only one obturator foramina, then
yes,
it is called as a correct position. Correct. What diagnosis here? T2 place, because glans ka jahan pe introduce kar rahe, where it is introducing the contrast, that area is not. That is one lacuna.
Not distancing. Penile urethra, there is some.
Another thing is mid penile area and penobulbar junction. There are two problems at two places.
Yes, sir.
So that the one is short segmental penobulbar stricture with probably luminal narrowing in the mid penile area.
Okay.
Without and we. जो ग्लांस का एरिया में इट इज नॉट कॉमेंटेबल, हो गया वो एरिया दिखता नहीं. तो ऐसा ये तीनों चीजें आपको बताने को आना चाहिए. कैन नॉट एबल नॉट एबल टू कॉमेंट ऑन द ग्लांस एरिया, मिड पेनल ल्यूमिनल नैरोइंग एंड सिगमेंटल, वेरी शॉर्ट सिगमेंटल पेनो बल्बर स्ट्रक्चर और ल्यूमिनल नैरोइंग. दैट इज थ्री थिंग्स तुमने बोलना चाहिए.
ओके सर.
Okay.
Fourth question.
Yes,
is,
and someone has already contrast exclusion. That is also finding.
So, what surgical treatment you will offer to this patient?
Consider it is as a mid penile luminal narrowing with peno bulbar short segmental stricture. Abhi mujhe bata do. Options. फटाफट बता दो.
Yes, sir. For mid penile
urethra,
we'll use substitution urethroplasty. Okay, sir. Substitution urethroplasty or augmentation urethroplasty. for penile urethra, and for a bulbar we can do VI single chance, or otherwise in complete urethroplasty can be done, sir, for two short segments.
Means what? Which urethroplasty? Complete urethroplasty.
BMG urethroplasty. Yeah, BMG urethroplasty can be done, sir. We can put a graft at both the positions.
Okay, that is
not a bad answer, but two, three options. One first option. For mid penile dorsal BMG urethroplasty for mid penile, and for penobulbar junction it is non-transecting urethroplasty again. Very yes. Short segmental, and lumen is there. The contrast is going up. So that is option yes. For penobulbar short segmental stricture. Three options: VIU, anastomotic urethroplasty, dorsal patch urethroplasty, and non-transecting urethroplasty. Four options for that particular area. Mid penile, definitely it is a long luminal narrowing, so it is dorsal only BMG urethroplasty, or agar BMG kharab hai to skin patch urethroplasty, superficial inner superficial skin patch urethroplasty. These are the two options for penile. Any questions, okay. Suggestions?
Okay. Next, Prashant, next.
Yes, sir. So what surgical treatment you will offer to this patient? How will you counsel this patient for surgery?
Pass, no, Kaushal.
Yes, sir. I will explain to the patient that there is a stricturous segment in the penile and bulbar urethra. So he may need a surgical intervention in the form of BMG urethroplasty, which gives a definitive results of more than 90% success rate. So VIU is he may have recurrence with the VIU. So BMG urethroplasty is the better option for this patient.
BMG urethroplasty for distal, mid penile luminal narrowing. So, in spite of going for VIU, I will prefer for anastomotic urethroplasty or transecting urethroplasty, patch urethroplasty at that. Your answer.
Yes, sir.
Because I say anyhow, you are going for surgery to the mid penile area. So, why you want to go for VIU? Because success rate is near about 20%.
Yes, and you will also say that if there are chances that he will have to go for, someone has said CIC. Okay, so in short, you have to write down about the diagnosis, what you are, they have written. So how will you counsel that? What is your diagnosis? What you are going to offer? What is the best treatment, as you said, and what is the other option, and why you don't want to do it, and about the dilatation or CIC regularly.
Sir, someone has already written in the chat box, counseling doesn't mean the only indication of the surgery, the type of the surgery. So you have to talk about the diagnosis, you have to talk about the type, need of treatment, you have to talk about the type, options for treatment, you have to talk about the complication of treatment, you have to talk about the post-operative long-term sequelae of that particular treatment, and follow-up. It's up to the counseling man. One line.
So, Kaushal, in this, you have to say that this is the, your diagnosis, what is that structure? Is the annular, this thing, hollow structure? The chances are very high that patient will develop a recurrence of the structure. The best option is, as you said, that buccal mucosal graft and other open surgery. But you can also do visual internal urethrotomy or whatever you want to advise, and he will have to come for a regular follow-up, right? And there are chances, yes, of complication is like a stricture, and patient may require a second surgery. Because it's only 2 months, you have to write down the most important things, fine? So what is an indication of VIU?
Sir, indication of VIU is the short segment anterior urethral and bulbar urethral stricture. Less than 1.5 centimeter.
Anterior.
Yes, sir.
VIU.
Yes, sir. Preferably in the bulbar urethra. Yes, sir.
In anterior urethra, will you like to do VIU?
We can do, sir, but...
Hostel, you can do anything. But you should tell short segmental, yes, film G, short segmental, film G, non-dense, bulbar urethral stick is the so only
indication. Why you will not like to do in a penile urethra?
करते हैं बहुत जगह पे, हम भी कभी कभी करते हैं, वो नहीं बोल रहा हूँ, लेकिन थ्योरी आंसर आंसर में वो नहीं आना चाहिए.
यस सर. यस सर, इट कैन कॉज स्पॉन्जियोफाइब्रोसिस सर.
Fine. Okay. Now, enumerate different graphs, use and features of ideal graph for urethra. Just enumerate. And which one is the best? You just...
Different graphs used are buccal mucosal graph, lingual graph. Also. Only three, sir.
They were asking about the graft. Graft. Graft means medical graft and free graft. There are two types of graft. So free graft.
That is flaps, no sir.
Then
medical flap.
Medical flap can be utilized as a graft.
Okay. Sir. Okay. Sir.
Okay. Yes, so sir. Question here is one oral cavity se shuru karo.
Yes sir. Buccal mucosa. Yes sir. Lingual line. Yes sir.
Then apna auricle
labial. Yeah. Yes sir.
Skin rehta hai wo skin. Then inner superficial skin. Then rectal mucosa. Then vein. These all can be used, na?
Yes sir.
Bladder mucosa. Bladder and rectal mucosa usually not commonly used. But commonly used is BMG, lingual, vein and inner superficial skin. Ye char agar bata diya. So anybody will be happy.
Yeah. Yeah. And the features of ideal graft for the urethra.
Ideal graft should be, sir, vascular. The take up of the graft should be good. And it should be elastic and distensible.
Mm-hmm.
And it should not form a scar. Or it should not contract.
See, someone has already written you moist and non-heavy.
Yes, sir.
So these are the two things, and as you say, stretchable, elastic. Okay.
Yes.
Should have an intima basically. Or. Okay.
Yes.
Fine. This patient is a chronic tobacco chewer. How will you manage? How your management will change?
If patient is tobacco chewer, we have to see if buccal mucosa can be taken for the as a graft. We can take a biopsy from that region. If it's a vascularity and there is no submucous fibrosis, we can take the graft. Otherwise, we can take a lingual or a labial graft.
Okay. Fine. Okay.